Everyone, assalamu alaikum. In this tutorial, we'll take a look what is Laravel route model binding. We'll understand what it is. Well, simply speaking, this means that injecting your model into the route system or binding your route and model together or build a connection with them. Now, if we take a look, if your application has a Laravel route model binding, you can have URL like this, which is also called a slug. So if you have Laravel route model binding, you can have slug in your URL, which could be very good for SEO or readable. Now, there are a few things to do before we go ahead and do route model binding. There are six things to do. First, we need to get a column name from database because this column name we'd use for route model binding or as our slug. So here I'm in my database. Here I'll use a title as my slug, as you can see. Okay, so I'll take this section or this column as my slug. You can create a new column and call it slug and take the string from that and you should be good to go. Then we have to pass a route name from a href tag from your Laravel blade. Let's go ahead and say it. So here I'm in the front end of my Laravel application. And over here, from here, I'll pass a route name. And for me, I'll pass a route name as this, post title, because I'm getting title from the database. And I also want to use this one as my slug. Do remember, I'm using for each loop to go through all the articles or posts I have. So after that, I'll save it. Then we need to create a route name with curly braces and method. Let's go ahead and do it. So for this purpose, I need to go to my web.php file. And over here, I'll create a route name. I'll create a new route, which would be get in my case. And I said that we want to create a route name with curly braces. Well, now with curly braces, it will make it dynamic. So here, this title within curly braces would be used as a slug. Now, this name should be the one you have in your database as well as the one you are passing from here. So they should have the same corresponding name. Otherwise, you might get error. And because of this one, we'll have a detail method. Okay, do remember, once again, this is dynamic. Then we have to bind the model into the method parameter name. So my method detail is defined in index controller. So I'll go to find index controller. And over here, I do have a method called detail. So over here, I have to get article title. Now I'm using this article model to get post from the database and show it on the front end, okay? So it could be any of your model and it could have any kind of name, doesn't matter, whatever the name of this article, take that name and come over here and create an object from that model. And with this, we are injecting model into our routing, as you can see, because now, because of this one over here, this section or parameters would get connected with this one. So this is called route model binding. And after that, we need to pass it, okay? Now on the front end, I'll take it as article and every object will be coming from title. So because we did route model binding over here like this, now Laravel would easily find corresponding post or record from the database based on this information. Okay, and then we'll pass the whole record to our front end. After that, we have to create a method named getRouteKeyName. So we need to create this method inside our model. Let's go ahead and do it. Model, and we'll go inside it and create a method and we'll call it public function getRouteKeyName. Do remember, this name has to be exactly like this. And from here, you'll return the column that you are going to use as slug. So in our case, we are using title. In our case, we are using title as a slug. So I'll save it. Remember, this, and this. They should have exactly the same name. I also suggest from here, you also pass the same column name. Otherwise, you might have an error. And after that, we need to pass it to the next view. So for passing it to the next view, we'd come to this index controller. And over here, actually, we already did it. So this is how we are passing the object to the next view. Now, my next view is detail.blade.php, which is this one. If you have done so far along with me, you should be good to go. Now, we'll go ahead and save it, and which we already did. After that, we'll go. So this is the app that I'm working, and this is the front end. Okay, right now, well, we do have over here, you can see at the bottom left, we have number as our slug, once again, over here, okay? But just now we used the title, so what we'll do, we'll go ahead and refresh it and hover over on it. As you can see that we already changed to title or the string we can see over here, okay? So now we'll click on them and we can navigate through and we see that we have string over here. But of course, this string need a little bit string manipulation. It has nothing to do with Laravel route model binding. It works. Okay? So that's how you work with Laravel route model binding. Thank you.